trauma specialist. Kirby Thorpe, myself, Daniel, Luke Vanderplas is going to help today and interview Daniel. And we've Carol Donnelly, one of race or calves specializes in. So I'll leave it over to Luke now and he can ask a few questions and tell people about the pigeons.
Today we are at the house of Daniel Irons, one of the big names in Belgium. He has a very good name. He's also chairman this year for 50 years for a big club. And he loves pigeons. Each year he go with a team from about 30 pigeons to Barcelona, and he's very consistent. In 2016, Daniel sent 29, and 27 birds were on the list. That was brilliant. Best result from all Europe. I give Daniel the honor. He's fantastic long distance man. Can you tell us something about the strain, Mr. Daniel?
The strain,
Bloodline?
Well, in the beginning, it started with pigeons of Sint Maartens, Norbert Norman, Joseph van den Broeke. And then after 2-3 years, more the pigeons of Van der Weeren, Anton and Lucy of Holland. And then they crossed those the pigeons. And I think I have a good result in the beginning. I play also at a little shorter distance of 500, 600 kilometer. But now the last year, I did a sample, the Valley long distance from Barcelona, Beau, Perpignan, Narbonne, Marseille. And the pigeons, it's the young pigeons who are not learned. They stay sample here at home. Perhaps it's possible that the oldest of the young pigeons I give to 100 kilometers to Arras. But the other ones stay here for older the first year. And the second year, for the yearling pigeons, they go important number to Narbonne. Narbonne is of here a distance 900 kilometer. And when you have 2 years, the hens normally go to Barcelona. The cocks no. The cocks when we have 3 years. And I play with pigeons for 5-6 years. So it's the reason I have at the moment 6 pigeons at to breeding. They won 5 times Barcelona. 6 pigeons, 6 hens, 6 hens who have won 5 times on Barcelona.
That's prizes 5 times in Barcelona.
And you still raise them next year? You still raise these 6?
No. They are after. After one, because when he did 5 years Barcelona, that they were 7 years old.
You stopped.
The first time it was 2 years, and 5 more Barcelona, it was 7 years, and then I stopped it. Because at the end of the visit, it's dangerous, and I have not to lose the pigeons with well, so good for also for me for breeding, and so I have a motto. All the children that I have are coming of Barcelona flyers.
Yeah,
with a very good palmarès.
You can ask, is that because he breeds off them each year? And he has children from them, and then when they're 7 years old, he can put them in.
You breed already when they are racer from them? Not.
Nederlands.
Kweekjaal van de duiven, terwijl ze nog aan het vliegen zijn van die goede duiven?
Yes. All my pigeons are gekoppeld, zullen we dat gezegd?
Koppeld.
At the 15th March.
15th of March.
All the birds. And they take all, they are all together. One or two young pigeons, birds. So I have only 20 couples.
20 breeding couples.
No more. So it's necessary, but also I think the
best flowers.
Got the pigeons of the the widows and the Barcelona flowers. Eh?
So what time is it?
I play Barcelona. Nest. So?
Yeah.
The cocks are widows.
So Daniel plays the cocks, the Barcelona and widows. And the hens go on a 2-day youngster.
Yes.
2 days.
2 days
old. Small youngster.
Yeah. It's well, my system. It's a system for 25 years.
But both the hens and the cocks fly equal.
It's always the same system.
When they are home from Barcelona, what's going on the rest of the year?
After Barcelona. But normally they don't go Perpignan. But come this year, because Barcelona was extremely not normal, I didn't know.
Hard.
Barcelona, I didn't. I stopped with all the pigeons after Barcelona this year. And normally, the Barcelona, the hens, and also the widows go to the most important, the greatest market, to Perpignan.
So all the pigeons fly to Perpignan?
Yeah.
How many kilometers?
Perpignan is also 1,000.
1,600 miles. Yeah. And yearlings go to Nabarn, 900 kilometers, 540 miles. All yearlings go to Nabarn.
All, not all. It depends who the situation is of it, because they are simple hands and cocks together without nothing.
They must win price from Narbonne to have a ticket for next year?
Oh yes, normally when they are good, on Narbonne, they are also good
later.
The year after this year. For example, this year, I gave after the hands, there was with 9 hands of 2 years on Barcelona, and they did also Narbonne the year before, and of the 9 hands I have 7 prizes.
Good
for the future.
Yeah,
And Nathaniel, with the youngsters, the first round the youngsters got to 60 miles, and the second round the youngsters stayed home, they're not trained.
What about the medicines? You use medicines or not much?
Medicines, sample, I give something contra trichomonas.
Canker.
And Paramyx, of course, because it's
compulsory.
You must do it. And for the rest, I prefer you must do
natural.
Natural as most as possible.
And today it's winter, we are in December, and birds are flying out. Eh? Some birds were flying out today.
Every day.
They go out, yes.
And you have problem with hawk?
Rofogel?
Yes. Also, yes. Yeah.
And also the good ones fly out?
But because when the pigeons are in good condition, it's not simple for the rofogels take in. Is it the rofogels? Yeah.
Luke, ask Daniel what age is the oldest breeders. We noticed before we were here, some of them was 18 years old.
What's your oldest pigeon at the moment? Who owns the DAF?
Oh, I think my third animal, I have many pigeons of high age, alleen many ages.
Goede duiven mogen van ouderdom sterven.
15 years.
Jij doet een goede duif niet weg, denk ik.
No. Die stay hier. Maar onze verbrengingen hebben koks en hens die of 12 jaar, 13 jaar, 40 jaar.
12, 13, 14 jaar old, de brengers.
Because it's normally when I take, example, the Barcelona hens. And they are flying, when they stop to fly, they are 7 years. Yeah. And then I met the good to breeding, and they stay there for like, 6 years, 7 years, and depends.
Een oude duiver met een jonge dauphin, of kijk je daar niet naar?
For me, I think it's not important that the bird is now old or young. I think it's not important. For me, I think it's not important.
And you know, I know the other result.
They are players, they say, well, it's not good when the pigeon is too old, but for me, it's not important.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, without pigeons 9 years old.
But the pigeon is in good, stay in good condition, yeah? And I say I had pigeons who stay very, very long time in good condition. It's also so bad van de wegen, hè? It's the same, hè? Also van de wegen, pigeons do the motor pigeons of 10, 12, 12 years old, and they were in good condition, but by me it's the same, it's also.
They look good.
Well, yeah. My veterinaire, it's just the name veterinaire, comes to do the injection for Paramixer, hè?
Veterinarian.
And I take the pigeons, and it's a very, very good player also. I take the pigeons, and then he goes, well, it's not possible. It's 12 years old. Is Amy? I think it's pigeon of 3-4 years, not of 12-30 years. That's the
Vitalite.
Confirmation. It's a pants.
The pigeons fight.
It's a pants, the pigeon. And, the origin and the constitution of the pigeon.
Well, what we do now, Eddie, is we're going to go for the first time ever, and then I just want to let you video some of the pigeons in the labs.
Racing loft at the moment. All the couples have eggs. 3 weeks ago, Daniel paired up the birds, but when the eggs are 10 days old, the eggs are, he take them away because he does not need the youngsters. The normal pairing is in March, 15th of March. Then all the pairs know very good where they are sitting. Beautiful pigeons. The condition is very nice. These are old racers, Mr. Daniel.
It's all
our vliegers here.
The most important, yes. For Barcelona.
Yeah, okay. Dit is een duif van 2011.
Ja.
Dat is een hele goede vlieger, denk ik.
Dat is een zeer goede, maar dat is een tweede ring van Perpignan. Van die, ja. Van welk die gedraaid heb.
Welk zijn zijn beste prijzen?
Prijs van buiten weet ik niet, maar die neemt...
Van Barcelona?
Ja, VVV, denk ik, geloof. Dat is van 2011.
Dit wordt zijn laatste jaar. Hij gaat nog 1 jaar vliegen.
Ja.
This pigeon is?
This pigeon is 2011. He has very good results. Next year, in 2018, it will be his last season. Then he's 7 years old. That's more than enough.
Beautiful pigeon. How many times has he flown Barcelona?
Very good racer, yeah. Daniel Thomas. This hen is 2006. She won first international Saint Vincent. She's almost 12 years old, in brilliant condition. Normal eggs this year. If normaal gericht nog in 2017.
Ja, ik heb een jongen. Ja, ik heb een jongen. Straks de keer.
Mooi. Naar beste kinderen. Barcelona vliegers, kinderen.
Ja, ja. In een hand die 15 jaar Barcelona vliegen.
Geef sommige hen, Luc.
This is also fantastic hen. She's 2008. Her name is I Have a Dream. International winner, Barcelona hens. Also fantastic hen. You're a good fencher. All the eggs from these two hens are still normal. They can do for a couple of years. I hope so. Same family and the two winners. Same family.
Same. No. Well, yes. A little, but not. Not,
not too close.
Completely. Yeah.
And you bring together.
Well, yes, it was the generation of two brothers. And they have the ascendants.
Yes, yes. Okay. You bring together the two lines from the two winners?
Yes, yes, yes.
She played Barcelona, played. Waar
is dat? Hoeveel
keer heeft ze Barcelona gevlogen?
Die? Three times.
Three times.
And after Israel stopped it then because she was the first. In 2018, dat klopt. In 2008 was ze. 2008,
2010. Hoeveel keer heeft ze Perpignan
gewonnen? Moet je kijken, dat staat in de reportage normaal.
Ja.
Een reportage, it's on the paper.
Ja.
Luc is the pigeon and the name is I Have a Dream. Because for me it was a dream and so we give the name I Have a Dream. And she was the winner of Barcelona in 2013. And she won also in Barcelona at 2011 and 2010, Perpignan 2011 and 2012. And then after the first prize in Barcelona, well, he stopped it. Then she was 5 years at this moment.